It said, warning, this facility contains chemicals known by California state government to cause cancer, infertility, and all this other stuff.
Oh, nice.
You enter at your own risk.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Universal.
Studios, baby!
Oh, you're not allowed to say baby anymore. That's so 1990.
What is it?
Chill, boyo.
What are we doing?
Standing here looking at you filming.
Watching mint bands like Rooney on the big screen.
Okay.
Go, follow
there
the
you are.
Onward
follow, ho. Yeah, this way.
Look, it's Kirsten Dunst! Oh, she's pretty. She's pretty. She's going on the list. All these cool rides. We got the Mummy, Van Helsing, Shrek, Jurassic Park. Back to the Future, baby! In fact, Van Helsing's just here.
Hello. How's everybody doing? Are you guys having fun?
Yay!
Are you guys having way too much fun? Too early in the morning.
See where it all happens.
Look, it's Ron Howard.
But before we get too far into the tour, let me give you the setup for our story. Universal got its start in
1980. Let's just get a shot. Oh, that's true. Hello.
Hello, this is Doug.
The camera can't see from the street. They don't build it as a waste. But an actor walks into one layout, guys. Go to the inside of these buildings in our stages where there's more control over lights and sound. Universal's got over 500 facades in the backlot, the largest collection anywhere. They range from city streets like these to Mexico, Europe, the Old West, even have ancient Rome. Well, take a look to your right, everybody. On the right side ahead, we have the famous clock tower.
No way.
Now Square, the Back to the Future films with Christopher Lloyd and Michael J. Fox. Well, those films, Mike Fox had to be really versatile because he played a lot of characters. Look over this corrugated steel building. Keep looking all the way up top, all the way up top, all the way. See what a facade is. There's our clock tower. There is nothing behind it. All they are interested in is what the cameras can see. We're being rerouted today because a new feature's been shooting in our metro area over the past 2 weeks, titled The Chasing Ghosts, a new horror sci-fi film starring Meatloaf and Michael Madsen. They've been working quite a bit.
Military units are rushing to the scene. The beast was last sighted near the 200 block of Old Fulton Avenue. We now go for live coverage on the scene for helicopter reporter Kelly King.
Down there. We've got to go down and warn them. Attention, people on the trap. You are in danger. Read
see, it's falling apart, JJ. You just want to go straight, dude, and bypass it now? Can't go straight? We'll never make it over the bridge. Random, dude. We're going over. Great. Hey,
that can't be good.
Remain seated and think light.
We're driving into England, that can't be good.
Town that can build you anything you need.
We have some fog effects too. The fog is made using misters. In the old days, they just put a chunk of dry ice on the set and pour hot oil on it. And they used oil because the fog was denser and stuck around longer. The weather effects create seasons, but they also provide obstacles. And conflict equals drama. Or comedy. Depending on how you use it.
That's a big cage.
Up ahead, we'll show you guys how rain effects are made. We'll cruise on down to Old Mexico. Crank on the sprinklers, and you got it. And it's not real advanced, but it works. The rain comes from sprinklers. Trees are built. Trees are watered, so it falls down naturally. This is California. When it rains like this, we have issues with flooding. But I wouldn't worry unless I was in the second or third car along the left side. Yeah, the rain comes from sprinklers. But it's made by dumping lots of recycled water from tanks on the hill.
We'll have that.
Sure, we don't know. Marty McFly was first played by Eric Stoltz. Michael J. Fox was Marty number two. Eric Stoltz, a great actor, but they felt the chemistry wasn't right, so he was replaced, and they shot everything all over again.
Good.
Now, if you're a fan of Mel Brooks, as you all should be, he's hilarious. In his classic film, History of the World, Part 1, there was a scene where he was dressed as Moses, and he parts the Red Sea. Well, he parted this one.
Wow, they did part the water. Impressed. Hey. Wow.
I'm going to stop this clip right here. As we are leaving the area, everybody look over your left shoulder all the way to the very back corner. Way, way in the back. You guys see those white columns back there, the white columns? That's the same spot that is on the screen above you. Same location. It's different these days. It looks a lot better, doesn't it? This table, oof, very important to movie making. That is where they keep junk food to munch on during the day. They say you can tell how good a production is by how much money they spend on the food. It's the truth. Now, it doesn't mean the movie is good. It means the production is good. Big difference. Let's look around, get some great picture. Oh, must be a friendly California aftershock. Nothing to worry about. Well, maybe not. So grab your stuff. Remain seated.
That can't be good. Uh-oh.
He dead. That can't be good.
From the 1960 Sweet. Alfred Hitchcock thriller Psycho, starring Janet Leigh and Anthony Perkins. That house up there is called a shell. Means it has all four sides, but barely enough in there to keep the thing standing. And it's built small to make it look like it's further from the motel than it was. Little thing called forced perspective. But by doing that, whenever Norman Bates stood in the